It's Wolfie-chan, and I'm back with another anime review, and this anime is The Brave Witches. It's a brand new series. It's up to 3 episodes in the dub, maybe up to more, but I haven't double-checked the app yet. But this is where I give you kind of my first initial impressions of it in the first 3 episodes, recommend it to you, and maybe we can finish the series together. Who knows? I kind of like this one. So, this one, I will have to admit, if you've watched The Strike Witches, it is a kind of sequel slash parallel to The Strike Witches, which The Strike Witches are, I have the link down below if you want to go see it. I also have it on one of the cards and more than likely probably the end screen. Strike Witches is a bunch of witches that basically use these machines that look like kind of like brooms. They don't look like brooms, but they kind of have that look of like they're supposed to be planes, and they use them on the legs, and only witches can do this. And the witches are fighting the Noroi, which basically has been kind of taking over the world. Nobody quite knows what they are or what use they have in there, but they are fighting them. And you find out that our main character, her dad actually made these kind of devices for the witches to use to fight Noroi's. So she kind of accidentally gets in it, and she's more of an elementary school student. And so she becomes a strike witch and helps out with the whole team. And I love that. But good gracious, good golly gosh, it has a lot of panty shots. And I swear some of the outfits that they wear are barely covering the underwear that they're wearing. And the camera angles, like, if they're having a conversation and the people are just like this, the camera angle is, like, pointed down in a weird angle. But it has a very great story to it, and I do like Strike Witches. So, when I started watching this one, I was like, is this not similar to Strike Witches? Maybe it's got some parallels, but then they mentioned the Noroi. And I was like, that seems a lot like the Strike Witches. But then you find out that it actually is a sequel, prequel kind of mix of Strike Witches. Because you find out that our main character's sister is already in the military fighting in the Noroi. And you find out that at least they live there in school to fight this and to train and to be more witch-like. You find out that the sister does not have the main character, does not have the capacity as much as she does to hold magic. So she kind of, on her equipment, like, is not straight and almost falls off a lot. But there's a challenge to ask for one of the students to help fight the Noroi. And she goes up against another student and finds out that she's very much wanting to grab them and protect all the other students, because one of them that she's fighting with accidentally kind of grazes a cliff or a structure and falls. And she basically catches her and grabs her and they fall and stuff like that, but she is then recruited to fight the Noroi, which you find out that her sister has a very big, amazing power, which her hair changes to red and her eyes change to red, and she can see the cores of the Noroi, and that's why she's the mostly acclaimed fighter of it, and so when she fights them and stuff like that, she activates power and can automatically just shoot. Well, she gets injured on the trip up to St. Petersburg, which is going to be her installation, and she goes into a coma? Like, truthfully, you could have just told me that she got, the wound was really bad, and she's conscious enough to realize things, but she just can't fight. Like, I'm okay with that, but she's unconscious. She didn't even fall. Like, her sister grabbed her, put her down, went back up to fight the Noroi. Like, cereal, But the I will admit that the panty shots are really like low played out now. The camera angles are more to their faces and more talking, and there's like even the outfits that they wear is longer to cover up those underwear. So you don't get a lot of panty shots, you do get a few. But this one is seems like more kind of focusing on the story, and I'm in love with that. I've loved the story and stuff like that. I just thought the panty shots were a bit absurd, and the angling, like, I like to see the fight, not the underwear. This one has more of a focus on the story, and I really do like it. It actually has a bit of the Strike Witches in this one in a newspaper, so I love that hint. That's what really made it click that they're in the same universe. And then the 104th or 5th Brave Witches. So it's very interesting, and you find out that her younger sister, our main character, takes her position in St. Petersburg and is trying to get her level up to her sister so she can fight more and be more competent at fighting. So far in the series, I love it. It is one of my more favorite stories, and I just really love this one. I'm quite glad that I stumbled upon this one and I'm starting to watch it because I'm in love with the Strike Witches and I have watched season 1 and 2. And if you want a review of season 2, tell me down below because I can definitely do that. But so far in the first three episodes, I definitely would say try it if you've watched Strike Witches and you're not into all those panty shots. This one is very story driven and I love it. So, if you like this little video I've made about the Brave Witches, definitely like it. Comment down below. Have you started watching this? Is this one of your kind of season watchings? And what do you think of it so far? As well as, who is your favorite character? I will admit that the main character's older sister is my favorite. Something about her is just so, like, commanding, and she understands. And she knows that her sister really wants to be a part of this, but she may not be that great at it. I love her. And I also have a biggest question, and maybe one of you guys can tell me if you've read the manga or anything like that, or if they talk about it in anything. What's up with the ears and tail? Like, in Strike Witches, the grandmother and the main character both have the same ears and tail. But in this one, the sister's ears and tail are totally different, look more bird-like, whereas her sister actually has ears like little fox or brown puppy ears and a tail. I'm kind of wondering about that because there's blood, but ears. And definitely subscribe because I do make videos. I do upload videos every day around 5 o'clock Central Time, 6 o'clock on the East Coast, 4 o'clock my time, and 3 o'clock the West Coast, and either an hour around there. So I do like uploading at 4 o'clock so you can get it at least after school and kind of enjoy yourself. And if you want to follow me on Twitter or Facebook, I have the links down below. I hope that you are having a very wonderful day. It's turned kind of chilly. That's why I have long sleeves. I know. I don't live in Alaska, if you're wondering. Wolfie Chan out. Bye, guys.